What's up, y'all? It's Demogenai. It's time for another one. So, let's do a little Star Wars talk today. And by the way, just gonna give you a little teaser. We're gonna continue this topic tomorrow on our live stream. So make sure you come and check out the live stream because I'm gonna continue this particular subject on tomorrow's live stream. So just make sure you come out and check that out because I wanna have an actual discussion with y'all and see how y'all feel about it. And obviously I can't do that on a pre-recorded show, obviously. So what we're gonna do is tomorrow, we will touch on some of this again and pause. And we'll continue this topic. But anyway, were the Jedi corrupt, arrogant? What would be the right word for them? And the reason I'm talking about this is because I saw people talk about this. This is actually a few weeks old, but I just didn't have the time to talk about it just because the way things popped up, we had other news that popped up. But this definitely sparked some interest for me to want to talk about, and especially when we combine what we're going to talk about tomorrow, again, teasing that, you'll see where, like, this all boils down to, yet again, it's kind of hard for me to say this all the time, but it's just crazy when we think about it. You had a company bought something for damn near $5 billion and then just changed everything. And of course, we have these debates going back and forth for what is, what isn't changed, and what's the same, who's a Mary Sue, who's a Gary Stu, all the stuff like that. But at the end of the day, the formula for what made Star Wars great has been changed. And this is, it's not just with Star Wars either. Mind you, this is a Star Wars topic right now. But it just seems like everything lately that I've seen me coming out, I mean, you'll have some few gems coming out. Cobra Kai is a standout. Mandalorian, okay. And I'm kind of digging WandaVision, but that's another story. But as far as, like, overall, it's like this thing when we have entertainment, it's like the fundamentals of the show or comic or whatever it is that you're into, they change. And then they look at us like we're the crazy ones. We say, hey, this isn't what made it great in the first place. This isn't what made XYZ great. You are changing it. But then, you know, people get labeled, you know, especially the fandom menace, get labeled as Istanbul's. But let's get into it, right? So this is an article from Screen Rant. And it says, Star Wars new canon keeps making Yoda even more of a failure. You see where we're going with this, right? You see this, right? So it says, Yoda is famously one of the Jedi's most famous masters, but the changes he made to the High Republic era Jedi Order resulted in their failure. So, I'm not going to go through this whole thing, but just from the reviews, overviews I've heard from people who actually have been reading the High Republic stuff, Yoda is on a sabbatical of sorts. He's actually not in charge of the Jedi Order. At the time, there is another Jedi Grandmaster at the time of the High Republic. Don't know who the person's name is. Whatever. Let's get into this because for me to get into this, so here it is right here. So it says, situated in almost a literal ivory tower, the prequel era Jedi Order was unbalanced. Their members were disconnected from the common people of the galaxy, taught to suppress their emotions and forbidden from forming attachments. Now you see this right here, just that right there, that opening part of the paragraph. That's going to be a key point of what we're talking about. That's a little more teaser, making sure I'm teasing you. It's going to be a little bit what we're going to be talking about tomorrow. But here's one of the things, and this is why I say when we talk about Disney buying Star Wars and then scrapping and basically changing the whole thing. Because if you knew anything about the EU, which is the proper storyline and timeline that I will continue to say that's what it is, I don't care what anybody says. That's my opinion. You can like whatever you like. I'm just saying, as far as me, the only true Star Wars timeline is the EU, George Lucas' Star Wars, 1 through 6, and that's it. That's what I consider. But if you was to pay attention to that, you would know one of the reasons why Jedi dress the way they dress is to be more like the common folk. They dress downward. They don't have militaristic gear. Kind of like, I don't know, what they were doing in the Clone Wars. In that particular instance, that's when they were swirled around in the dark side. And then walking around with, battle armor and stuff like that, which some of the past Jedi did do that in the EU. And they went to change that to make themselves more, more acceptable to the common folk. That line right there annoys me because that's, once again, shows that you don't know what you're talking about. But let's continue. Since the Order was a political tool at the disposal of the Supreme Chancellor with little to no oversight, despite their members possessing unimaginable powers. In Legends, the New Order was a vast improvement over this. Luke's Jedi were encouraged to have lives outside of being Jedi. They were taught to control their emotions rather than suppress them or being controlled by them, and attachments such as romantic relationships were allowed. While not political, the New Jedi Order, was a far cry from being the New Republic's almost paramilitary unit in the previous order. So, here's where we're going to wrap this up. It says, as shown in the Star Wars High Republic, the canon Jedi Order, this is where we talk about the new one, similar to the Legends era, New Jedi Order over their time, the Order allowed attachments, but they did not encourage them. They were almost completely apolitical. They stressed the importance of individuality, with each Jedi defining the Force and their connection to it differently. Yoda's personal philosophies and definition of the Force gradually become the standard accepted truth of the Jedi Order during his time as Grandmaster. Leading to the Jedi Order in the prequel trilogy, Yoda's Jedi Order was corrupt, okay? Complacent and emotionally unhealthy, which was unfortunately exactly what the Sith needed to enact their revenge on the galaxy. So, the Jedi being corrupt. I look, in no way, at least in the proper version of Star Wars, did I ever get the idea that the Jedi were corrupt. Now, when you say corrupt Jedi, that sounds like, Jedi doing back in deals and doing political assassinations and stuff like that. There was no, at least I didn't read any. And mind you, I have probably about 30 books of the EU. I don't have all of them, but out of 30 I've read, sure, the Jedi had their issues, but there was nothing like, oh, they were greasing the palms or getting their palms greased by somebody in the Republic era, right? Or the government, I should say. So, but I don't really like to call the Jedi arrogant, and this is why I have the thumbnail that I had, because that actually made me think about in Attack of the Clones, when you had the librarian, the Jedi Master librarian, and Obi-Wan says, look, I can't find Kamino. He says, well, if it's not on the map, it does not exist. And this is the arrogance that the Jedi had, and I think that was more of their flaw than saying they were corrupt. Now, one could say, the attachment thing. Listen, the Jedi were based off, it's almost like a monk type of deal. It is their religion. So one would say, yeah, maybe they was a little too harsh with it and too strict with that. But I wouldn't necessarily say that was necessarily just the downfall. What I think the problem was the fact that because they looked, which by the way, Jedi could be married. There were Jedi who were married in the Yoda's Jedi Order. So that did happen. And once again, this will lead, I'm trying not to spoil what I'm going to talk about tomorrow, but this will lead to what we're talking about tomorrow. So it's the attachment thing that I think was, if you want to say the two things I would say was that was the biggest flaw is the attachment thing, which was, the looking down on having attachments, and obviously their arrogance. I would say what the Jedi's issue was, because that really was what led to Anakin kind of like doing what he did, because they were so arrogant in their beliefs that, oh, you can't do this. And you couldn't see that Anakin, Anakin had, obviously, even with Pat and Attack of the Clones, Obi-Wan knew that Anakin has felt some type of way about Padme. You know what I'm saying? And for them not to overlook that, again, I think that speaks to their arrogance, right? Like, oh yeah, he wouldn't do that. He's chosen one, blah, blah, you know, whatever. But at the end of the day, I'm just getting a little annoyed of them, you know, putting OG characters on blast, downgrading them, making them feel like, you know, making them be like they're less than what they should be, you know, talking about like with Yoda and stuff like this. And no, I don't think the Jedi were corrupt. I think that they just had their two major flaws was their arrogance and their, you know, their you know, lack of attachment rule, I think was one of their biggest flaws, or two of their biggest flaws, sorry. But how do you guys feel about that? Do you think the Jedi were corrupt? Were they arrogant? What were they? What do you think the Jedi were? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit the notification bell so you can get my videos on the job. Remember, you can't be good, you're good at it. Peace.